Hi, my name is Aaron Starks, Chief Revenue Officer and Managing Director of Business Services at World Trade Center, Utah. Today, I'm really excited to run through a scenario with you. Imagine you wake up, it's Monday morning, and you're looking at a 7-lane interstate right in front of you. And in the middle of that interstate, you see a box. And in the box, you're told is $1 million. Are you going to risk your life, navigate the traffic, and try and go get that package? Many would. Let's say you're successful. You venture out, you avoid the traffic, you get out to the middle, you bring the box back, you're successful, you open it up, and sure enough, there's $1 million in there. You took a calculated risk that paid off. Now it's Tuesday morning. You wake up. You walk out into the middle of the interstate again, same package. You think, this is great. I'm going to multiply my wealth here. You take the package back to the shoulder, you open it up, and there's $1. Was the risk worth it for $1? Many would say it was not. As entrepreneurs and investors, these are the decisions we make every day. Let me tell you about a scenario that I recently had. Sitting down with a company here in the state of Utah who wanted to assess their international capabilities, feeling that they had potential and having seen great success in their backyard, they said, perhaps international markets make sense based on where we're at right now. I sat down with them. I said, tell me about your portfolio. Tell me about your international objectives. What do you want to accomplish? And they said, well, we feel really strongly about going to Pakistan. I said, Pakistan? Tell me more about Pakistan. They said, we love Pakistan. In fact, my mother-in-law served a mission there 35 years ago. That's why we're going to Pakistan. This is a $500 million company making this decision. We take risks every day, but some are completely unnecessary. I spent 10 years with a local company with international ties, Franklin Covey, and it was a very scrappy and entrepreneurial experience that I had over the course of a decade. I was hired to take all of their content and training programs to international markets. Hired as employee number 3 in their international division, my task was to conduct the market research, do the business analytics, and reach out and make contacts that would help the company be successful in entering these new markets. So on day one, I sat down at my desk, I started picking up the phone, and I started calling all kinds of countries. Eventually, I started flying to these countries, meeting with partners, the American Chamber of Commerce, other World Trade Centers, ministries of trade, commerce, economics. And my job was to sit and do the due diligence, to first understand what the market was doing, who were the players in the market, where was the market trending, what other products or substitutable services were at play in the market, and for what prices. Well, as a one-man team, it was very hard for me to do all of this, especially going into a market that I knew nothing about. This is not unfamiliar to companies of all sizes. Over the course of 10 years, we took Franklin Covey into 23 markets throughout Asia. Eventually, I moved to Tokyo, Japan, where I oversaw operations for all of Asia. And as I reflect on that experience, I'm grateful for the success that I had, but there were a lot of things that I did incorrectly. Many, many mistakes. I ventured out into the interstate hoping to find $1 million package and sometimes got nothing. At World Trade Center Utah, we've made an investment in ourselves so that we can fulfill our mission. And the mission is to accelerate growth for Utah companies through our networks, services, and programs. And I want to tell you about how we're doing this so that you, as an entrepreneur and business owner, don't have to make the same mistakes that I did in my 10 years at Franklin Covey. So in Utah, we have the most diverse economy in the United States. Every industry in the world is in our backyard. We're young, we're entrepreneurial, we're hungry. 140 languages are spoken here. There's more money in the market now than there ever has been in the state's history. And that's a great thing, but that means that there's more risk and more ambition. And at World Trade Center Utah, what we want to do is help mitigate that risk. Now, we're not going to sit down with Boeing and advise them on how to move airplanes or how to manufacture aerospace components. That's not our job. But we do know that at some point in your company's growth, international markets become a consideration. They have to. 95% of the world's consumers live outside of the United States. So you have to do your due diligence as a business owner, and you have to know where you're going. But doing that can be very technical and very complex. So our team at World Trade Center Utah is helping companies grow. In fact, in 2021, last year, we helped over 180 companies with these services that I'm about to describe today, generating $80 million in new trade and investment opportunities for local brands. We feel very good about our impact, and we feel really good about the future of our organization and the state. So first and foremost, when I sit down with a company, I want to know if you're going international, I want to know how well you know your markets. Tell me about your buyer persona. Sometimes when I sit down with a company and I say, show me your buyer persona, they say, well, what's a buyer persona? Well, I can tell you that a buyer persona is absolutely critical to any brand management efforts and any distribution internationally. If you walk into Nike's headquarters in Oregon, they have cardboard cutouts of their buyers. They can tell you exactly what the demographic is based on the product that they're selling. They can tell you about Eddie the entrepreneur, who's 26, has a MacBook Pro, wears Nike Air Max Pros, right? Is single, lives in a metropolitan area here in the United States. They are dialed in with their products. They know exactly who they're marketing to and how they're positioning the company. We help companies draft their buyer persona so that when they go to India, they know what the Indian consumer wants. They know how to position their product. They know what their value proposition is. They can answer the question, why would a consumer choose their brand over their competitors in a foreign market? That's the power of a buyer persona. This process I'm walking you through right now is called pathfinding. As we construct your buyer persona and we get really clear on what you're doing internationally, from there, we help develop using our algorithm. We've made big investments into research, data, and analytics, and we conduct both the macro and micro market research reports that you need to make an informed decision. So we advise companies, if you're going international, don't go to more than two countries at one time. You don't have the bandwidth or the resources to do that. Even our billion-dollar brands would say the same thing. It's not smart to be a mile wide and an inch deep. So for you to choose those two markets, here's what we're going to do. We're going to look at three indices. We want to know what the political stability in a market is. Obviously, we're not going to go to Afghanistan right now. We're not going to go to Ukraine or Russia. It's not politically stable enough for us to make good decisions for your company. We also want to know what the market is doing. What does the market potential look like? Five-year growth averages, market saturation. We want to know what your competition's doing, what similar products and services are being sold for. And then from there, we want to know what the overall ease of doing business is. Tell me about the regulatory or compliance hurdles that you face. How hard is it for you to get a product into that country? What are tariffs doing? There are all kinds of implications, but based on these indices, we can boil the world down to five countries that make sense for your company. And then in partnership with your team, we choose two of those countries. Now, let's say that Tokyo, Japan is your number one choice for your product. And let's say Bangkok, Thailand is your second market. Okay, great. We're going to choose two of the five, Tokyo and Bangkok. From there, we're going to get very microscopic and detailed with our market research. We're going to tell you what it's going to take for you to get your product to Bangkok or Tokyo, what the estimated landed cost of goods is, what regulatory barriers you need to overcome would be. And by the end of this process, we call this pathfinding, we've put your company on a path to its next international opportunity, thus mitigating risk and helping you make an informed decision and preventing you from going to a market that you know relatively nothing about. Then we jump into our second phase, okay? If all we sit and do is tell you where to go, we haven't fulfilled our mission. Our mission is to accelerate your growth as an organization. What we now need to do is tell you how to get there. And that's very, very important. So our team has been hard at work for 2 years now, vetting service providers in and out of the state, service providers that can provide the help and support that you need to be successful. Now, if I'm going to Tokyo, Japan, and I manufacture headphones, how am I going to get my headphones to Tokyo, Japan from southern Utah? Well, there are logistical implications in that decision. We need a freight forwarder. We need shipping provided. We need to know what supply chains are doing. So we have a team of experts that we can call in and seamlessly provide help to you as our client company. Perhaps you need to know what the tariff lists are doing and what sanctions are in place in a foreign market. We have the right attorneys and trade representatives on hand to help us with that. Or perhaps you're excited to jump to Tokyo, you know very little about the market, and you realize that before you ever go there, before you ever book your Delta flight, your buyers, partners, investors in that country are going to get to know you first through your website. Is your website translated? Is it localized? In the 21st century economy, our websites say everything about us. They are our source of credibility in the international world. How developed and optimized is your website? If it's not, we can help with that too. This phase two of our engagement helps you prepare to go international. We do the due diligence up front. If we need to protect your IP, if we need to ensure that you know enough culturally about the market, we can do all of that leading up to this next phase, landing. This is where the rubber meets the road. This is where we execute the game plan that we followed in phase two. Now it's all about market entry. We've selected your markets. We've told you how to get there. Now let's get there. We do this in a number of ways. As an organization, for over 15 years, we've been flying cohorts of companies from Utah all around the world, sometimes with the governor's office, sometimes on private business trips to Dubai, to Japan, to Mexico. But through our private networks of contacts, our embassy relationships, we're able to open doors for you as a company that you otherwise wouldn't get into. And so if you've gone through and done your due diligence, you've selected your markets, and we determine that, you know what, the best way for you to seed the market in the United Arab Emirates is to go and participate in a trade show, we can help you with that. Maybe it's going to Japan for a week, and through our resources, we set up a personal itinerary for your company so that when your boots on the ground in Tokyo, we can introduce you to competitors, buyers, industry players who are going to help you have a meaningful experience in that market so you can make a decision. You know what I love about this process? Is that some companies tell me they're just not ready to go international after they thought they were. If that's the response our team is getting, then I know we've done our job. Because you can be $20,000, $30,000, $50,000 into a market that you know nothing about. Or you could spend a fraction of that with us, partner with us, have access to our networks, programs, and services, make an informed decision, mitigate risk, and be successful in a market. That's what we're here to do. So we've been doing this for 2 years. We've seen great success with this. We've helped multi-billion dollar brands. We've helped the 23-year-old who was in my office who recently told me that he makes $750,000 a year recording himself playing video games on YouTube and wanted to know how to expand his international reach. Again, every industry in the world is in our backyard here in Utah, and we feel like it's our mission to help all succeed abroad. Of all the decisions you can make and get wrong, don't let this be one of them. Let us partner with you and bring our resources to your team. Thank you.